everyone. Welcome to the third day of Animal Crossing, or the third video, I guess. Animal Crossing, City Folk, welcome. Ah, came to play, huh? September 10th? Sure. Yeah. Who am I? I'm still king. Meeting up every day is pretty sweet. I know. Just wait, let's see if I can keep it up. And it looked like it was raining today? That's exciting. Not exciting for the rain now, but for what's going to happen tomorrow. Let's run around and talk to some of our neighbors. Let's go on like a quick little run around looking for fossils. That's kind of the most important thing. We're going to have to, let's maybe look for the money rock. See if I can like line myself up. Oh, jeez. Oh, you're... There's no turn in place. Your character has to like walk forward. Our turning rate is awful. All right, let's just back out of that. Let's try this again. Yay, all that work for nothing. Woohoo! I'm so good at video games, you guys. Now, you know what? Let's chat with some of our friends. Hello, Winnie! Like, hiya, King. This rain is for seriously bumming me out. I like the rain, though. It was actually raining today and yesterday here where I live, IRL. It's been fantastic, except for we don't usually get thunderstorms here where I live. Like, I could probably count the number of thunderstorms since I've moved here on one hand. I've been here for like 5 years or something. And we've had like two or three in the past like 72 hours. It's been crazy. We had one a couple days ago that was like really, really fun to watch. I actually went and just stood outside in the rain and watched for a while. The lightning was nuts. It was like a strobe light. Like the whole sky was just lighting up and flickering and flashing constantly. It could have been like a concert or something, but it wasn't. It was thunder and lightning. Not much thunder. And then last night, boy, we're going off on this whole weird tangent, aren't we? This is great. Last night, it was pouring rain and there was not much lightning. But every flash of lightning had the really like long, rolling thunder cracks that came with it. So just like a quick little flash and then just like... with the thunder. Oh, it was great. It's fantastic. Both times, power flickered. I think the first night, the power went out for like an hour or something. That kind of sucked. I was gonna visit the city, but I'm afraid I'll slip in a puddle or whatever. Yeah, we're gonna deal with the city eventually, but we gotta take care of, you know, home first a little bit. Stupid rain! Why? Oh, I'm sorry you feel that way, Winnie. I need, like, a fashion check on Isle Me. Hey, okay. So, how am I dressed today? You have, like, a cow-patterned dress? You really don't seem super formal. I don't want to see you look slobby. Fine. Perfectly neutral. Am I really that, like, middle of the road? But I thought I was being current with trends while all expressing my total individuality and stuff. I guess I don't really know what that all means. Bummer. Hey, okay. Oh, I'm sorry, Winnie. We're gonna chat with more of our friends today. That's the goal. This is cool. That means that in the next video, there will... Hello. There will probably be gyroids to dig up. Ugh, I hate having trees that are directly behind each other like this. We're gonna have to like chop them down and replant some so that they're staggered. A lantern fly? But where do I put the kerosene? Boo! Boo! Animal Crossing puns, you're terrible. We're gonna shake a couple of wet trees. Only a few. I really don't want to get stung by a bee today. Or ever again, but, you know. Okay. Gosh darn it, the freaking pitfall. Ugh. Why is there one of those every day? Barry. Get out of here. Oh, and we can take the monarch butterfly to, what's his face, too? Oh no, I fell on a pitfall. Boo, who could have known that it was there? I might like look for the money rock on my own after I record this. You guys don't have to watch me run around digging holes and punching rocks with a shovel. That seems like not great content to me. We can check this one though, because it'll knock us into the lake, so we don't have to like dig holes. I'm lazy. Oh, hello. You are disgusting. If I put you in my body, will I live forever? That also seems terrible. Oh my gosh, my aim. There we go. A centipede. It's got a million legs. Or, you know, 100. Yeah. 100 and a million are basically the same number. There's another cool bug on a tree here in the rain. I don't know if it's because it's raining or if it's because it's kind of eveningish or both. A walking stick. A stick that walks? What sorcery is this? We should probably just take these things to Blathers. I wanted to plant some flowers today. Let's do that. Let's go have a chat with somebody like Static or something. I don't know. Go visit Lucy. Hey, there's a recycling pail. Recycling bucket. How you doing, Nook? Do we have anything to sell? Two peaches. Sure. It's my own username from an alternate universe. Yay, 200 bells. Bottom one's medicine, so white roses is nice. It is quite a bargain. Do we want, like, are we interested? Dirt clod wall. Ugh. Okay, well, that kind of answers that question. Are we interested in getting, like, cool carpets or wallpaper or anything yet? I don't think so. I think we will be when we start trying to decide what what fashion to put in the house, like how to make it look, when we get around to the interior design aspect. Ooh, words are really hard right now, apparently. Harder, exactly as hard as always, which is to say nearly impossible. When we get around to like designing what our house is gonna look like inside, which will happen when it gets bigger, then I think we'll worry more about that stuff. Okay, let's go check around here. Any fossils? Any cool bugs? Anything? Nothing? Nothing. Boy, look at how wide-eyed my face is. We gotta get like some fashionable clothes or something. I'm so sad I didn't get that pirate hat. I completely forgot about it. I'm still so sad about that. Whose house is this? Violet's house. Oh yeah. Violet, do you like flowers? You can have some flowers. And we'll plant some red pansies, and we will plant... Nope. We'll plant some white roses. Lovely. Chasing around the little fish. Yeah, this is another easy rock where we don't have to like do any digging or anything, so we can just... Yeah, there we go. Okay, perfect. Now I don't have to do this on my own today. We're probably gonna just check a couple of rocks every day, and then if we don't find the money, I'll do this on my own. The idea of putting a thing behind you, where, like, the reason you would dig a hole or stand up against the cliff edge or whatever, is because it knocks you back every time you hit it with your shovel, and if there's not something behind you holding you close to it... Agent S? Who are you? Did you just move here? Are you new? I think we have a new person here. Are you a squirrel? Are you a superhero? Sniff, also known as... you gotta love the smell of a new house. Oh, hiya, I'm Agent S. Are you a secret agent? Are you a race car driver? Are you a superhero? Are you all of the above? What are you? Who are you? What do you do? Are you an actor? Actress? I'm so intrigued by Agent S. I don't think I've ever seen Agent S in any of my towns before. This is so cool. Bob, I've seen a lot, actually. Like, surprisingly, in most of my Animal Crossing towns. It seems like he's just always there. Oh, hi, I'm Agent S. I'm gonna, like, take the world by storm. Teehee. There's lots to learn about living on your own. That's why it's awesome to have you, sidekick. Ooh, am I your sidekick? Oh, I'm even more excited now. Agent S, you're my favorite person in the whole world. Oh, I'm in your way. I'm sorry. We can totally hang out later, but I've got a ton of stuff to do right now. Sorry, sidekick. That's all right. I would hate to be a bad sidekick on, like, my first day on the job. I'm getting all flustered now. I'll just leave you to it, Agent S. You guys, I think we have a genuine superhero here in town. I'm so excited. I'm so unbelievably excited. In words... cannot express my excitement. Somebody's over here making noise. Oh, you got like a flea or something. That's gross. Yeah, ew. I'm not dirty, am I? I don't want you to think that I'm gross. Hey, okay, too late. Gross horse. What a disgusting creature. Fine, just more stuff to take to Blathers. Oh, thank goodness. I was really worried that I'd accidentally dig up the flowers, and I don't want to do that. Oh, cool. All right, time to go pay a little visit to Blathers. Speaking of, we have stuff to give him. Let's go give him some stuff. Hello, Bob. Hey there, King. When it rains like this, I just cannot keep my eyes open. I love the sound of rain. I can listen to that all the time. Although, yeah, that would probably put me to sleep too. Hey, how do you think my clothes make me look? Why do you make that sound? Why do you say that? Way cool, super cute, over the top? Pretty over the top. What? Really? Is that like all you can eat fried rice and pasta salad? That's pretty over the top too. Is that even a thing? I don't know. Well then, I guess the only way to accessorize this outfit is with a big old plate of vanilla pudding. What does that mean? What does any of that mean? I am so confused. All right. Yeah, I'm really wishing there was like an extra bridge or something there. It is kind of a hassle to get here. Oh, and we have weeds everywhere. Ugh. Hello, Blathers. I have things. I hope you like bugs. I'm sorry, but I have more bugs for you. I know you don't like them. I don't either. Oh yeah, we have all the money. That's why my pockets are full. Completely forgot about that. Here's a monarch butterfly. It is a nice bug. It's very pretty. Monarch butterflies are quite colorful, aren't they? As it happens, the colors indicate that they're poisonous. I certainly start to feel queasy when I look at one. Well, that happens with all the bugs. Blech, enough, I say. Our thanks for the donation. I shall endeavor to keep this wretch safe and happy. I do have more. We got some weird ones. Here's a flea. It was from that gross, disgusting horse. I dare say that is a flea. Yes, rather astute. Who now? Have you ever had a chance to look at a flea up close and personal? No. I go out of my way to avoid looking at bugs ever, whenever I have the opportunity. Given the chance between looking at a bug and not looking at a bug, I will opt for option number two any day of the week. They're utterly noisome. Especially vulgar are their flattened bodies, which allow them to wiggle into all sorts of places. Oh, mercy, I may need to sit on the floor for a moment. All the stock of fleas has me rather woozy. Poor Blathers. Alright, we got some more stuff. We have the million-legged hundred-peed. Yeah, I kind of wish we could skip that opening bit. I get that you bugs, queasy, don't let them out, etc. Foulness! Hold a moment. I do rather poorly with shiny, wriggly, wretched creatures like this one. Indeed, centipedes are quite fast to boot. What? Yeah, he was zooming all over the place. I had a really hard time catching him. That has nothing to do with me being real bad at aiming my net. If the beast attacks us, how will we flee to safety? Good question. Also, you can't kill it unless you have the Mortal Blade. Moreover, they have hard shells, so we can't stop it with a furious stomping. No, you need the Mortal Blade. I just said that. We are doomed. We are doomed. Brothers, you're building an army of insects here. If they break free of their cages, the world is over. Lanternfly. This thing was enormous. I dare say that is a lanternfly. It is said that the diet of sap from a lychee tree makes the bodily fluids of the lanternfly sweet. That's disgusting. It's also said the proper way to try them is to break off the tips of the horns and sip them like straws. Disgusting. It is also said that anyone who does any of these things is officially googly boogly out of his or her mind. Yes, I will agree with that one. Yep. This could basically be me running the museum, by the way, except Blathers is way more knowledgeable about the bugs than I would ever care to be. I think I've mentioned this before. There's going to be a lot of comparisons to Animal Crossing New Leaf. In New Leaf, you can just say, here's a whole bunch of, like, things to donate. Here's, like, 10 of them. Please donate all of them. And he'll just be like, oh, thank you for all of the stuff. That's very kind of you. And that's it. It's one conversation. We don't have to go through this over and over and over again. Walking sticks can skillfully disguise themselves as twigs or thin branches. What deceptive wretches. Just imagine going to grab what you thought was a twig and having it go squish in your hand. Ugh, gross. Such epic foulness! I agree. Just thinking about that dark day gives me owl bumps. Ooh, it's the top of the hour. That's our town song being played on the bell. We still gotta change that. I still don't know what to change it to. Alright, enough of the creepy crawlies. Nope, get out of here. And now... fossil. Fascinating. I have you now, fossil. Aha! This reluctant beauty tried to remain anonymous, but none resist Blathers. What you have there is another stegosaurus torso. Okay. Alrighty then. Well, let's go see how much money that's worth. How weird that we've gotten two fossils so far. And then we've gotten a duplicate of one of them. That's kind of crazy. I don't know how much a stego torso is going to be worth. Fossils are usually worth a fair bit of money. Alright, Senor Nook. What you got? How much money do you want to give me? Here is a genuine dinosaur. Fossil. How much you want to give me for this? 4,500. Yeah, that's pretty good. I was expecting a couple thousand. I was not expecting almost 5,000. That's a lot. That feels good. Okay. Let's stack up some cash here. There's another 8,100. That's a lot of money. It feels like a lot of money. It is a lot of money. It matches the increasingly large quantities of money we're going to have to donate. We're going to owe Nook. We're going to have to pay back. Welcome, Bank of Nintendo. Leofall Branch. Pay our mortgage. Nine. Yay! We paid off the whole debt! Woohoo! We're debt free! Oh, I love our clapping pelican in the background there. Yahoo! No more debt for me! My house is all paid off! Hooray! I think if we pop in here and talk to Mr. Nook, I think he'll offer to upgrade. I think we have to talk to him. It might not be till tomorrow, but... Yes, yes, hello to my good friend King! Thanks so much for paying off your house loan in its entirety. Such a day! Oh yeah, here we go. I always knew you'd finish paying it off, King. It does get me thinking. May I ask if you find your current house to be a trifle too small? Several trifles, actually. Wouldn't it be nice to rebuild your place a little bigger, hmm? Yes, yes, then you could buy more furniture to fill it. Oh, I see. You've got quite the racket going on here. Expand the house so that you can sell more very expensive furniture for it. So you want this, yes? Yes, please. I know it very good. You're a real go-getter, King. So what color roof would you like? Ooh, we get choices for the roof. I kind of want green. I don't know if we have other options. Aqua? Pea green? Pink? Purple, brown, black, white, somber colors? Okay, let's go for aqua. Now the construction should be completed by tomorrow, so get ready to be impressed. Oh yes. Ooh, I'm excited. Tomorrow's gonna be such a good day in Animal Crossing. I'd like to know how he's completing the construction on the house. Like, what am I doing? I'm going to sleep in the house and then sleeping through the construction that's happening in there? Are they, like, moving me out of the way? I don't know. One more thing, and then I'll try to shut up about New Leaf for at least for the rest of the episode. You can pick in New Leaf when you upgrade your house. Like, what specifically are you after? Do you want a basement added right away? Do you want the main room expanded? Do you want the attic expanded? Like, what are you after? It's just got so many nice little quality of life improvements. Still trying to finish, like, just looking around for fossils. There should be at least one more out here. I still haven't done my homework and figured out how many thing of each thing every day. I thought there were more than just two, but I don't know. Oh no, don't run through the flowers. Be careful. Don't stomp on the flowers. Do not destroy the flowers. Let's go see if the Able sisters have any cool fashion today. Maybe I'll get super, super lucky and we'll have the pirate hat back. That would be great. Although now I feel like I need to find like a cool sidekick costume, right? Like a superhero thing? Now that I am officially Agent S's sidekick. Oh, it's the gross horse again. Boo! If hating the rain is bad, then I want to be really bad. Hey, King. Oh, we already fashioned you. You're kind of slobby. Still middle of the road. All right. I wish you had something new to say, but that's fine. Whatever. Pink zap suit? A blue zap suit? Ooh, it's really hard to say no to that. I think we might get both of the zap suits. They're both pretty good. A durag. I'm gonna say no. Not quite what I'm after. However, how come? Oh, I don't get to wear it out. I have to put it on separately. Good grief, game. All right. That's much better. Blue hero look. Yeah. Okay, I can't actually, like, wear the zap suits around, right? We don't want anybody to know our secret identity. But, we got a couple of zap suits. That feels pretty nice. Cool. Jeez, and we're already, like, we've been doing this for, like, 25 minutes, half an hour almost. Feels like we haven't even done anything. Let's go pop around and talk to a couple of friends. We met Agent S. We talked to Winnie. Oh geez, where am I? Where are houses? How does town work? I kind of wish we could, like, remove these houses from the map. Because this is one of the houses we could have bought that we didn't. And like, yeah, it's there for if people are going to co-op and stuff in the town, but... Oh yeah, this is Lucy's house. Let's do this. But like, nobody is doing that, so I'm just playing by myself. Please let me remove the unused houses. They're cluttering up the place. Oh, King, welcome to my humble household. Make yourself at home. I shall. What a lovely little home. I like your sewing machine. Oh. It's making noise, because it's going. Oh, I could turn it on and off. That's cool. I think the heater's making noise, too. Oh, that's right! I had a favor I wanted to ask of you. Oh, perfect! I'm all ears. My house layout feels so stale these days. What I really need is something really playful. Do you know where I could find some furniture like that? Snoink. I'd even be willing to take your hand-me-downs if it saved me the trouble of finding one myself. I mean, I would just go buy something from Nook. Sadly, this is not really a thing that we can do. Oh no, you're in a bad mood, I'm so sorry! Oh no, I'm ruining everything! I'm such a bad friend. Oh, this is why I avoid trying to talk to people in real life. Yeah, let's go say hello to Static. Let's go ruin his day also. We've accused a flea-ridden horse of being gross and told them that they're very middle of the road fashion-wise, and we've refused to give a pig person our hand-me-downs. Quilts can be, quilts' days can be ruined. Hey, you are king, this is perfect. See, I've got something I need your help with, pal. King, I've been meaning to ask you, would you do your old pal a favor? Well, I'm not asking you to build the pyramids, just to take this package to a friend, because, yeah, I could do that. You're a real lifesaver, king. I just can't be seen with something as silly as a present. Oh. Ever. Okay. Oh, right. Go give this to Lucy. Yeah. I think he just gave me an hour? Or like... No, we're like 10 minutes into the hour. So he gave me either 50 minutes or an hour or 50 minutes. I don't know what time it is right now. I don't know how time works. Hello, Lucy, I'm back. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to ruin everything. Here, take a present. Let's be friends again, please. Evening. Snoink. How are you doing? Great. Here, I got a package for you. Oh, what did you bring me? A gift from Static? I wonder what brought this on. Oh, look at this. It's some checkered tile. Such a nice gift. I don't know if I can accept it. Thanks for delivering my present to me, King. If you're into Static, say thanks for me. Snoink! Do we actually need to go thank Static? I don't know. Let's go say thank you on behalf of Lucy to Static. We're just running errands for people. But you know what? It's okay. This is what you do in Animal Crossing. I didn't mean to lay in his bed. Isn't it past your bedtime? Delivery's done! You did it! Excellent, King! You'll go far in the delivery biz. Thanks, pal. I guess I owe you one. It's not really a proper thank you, but I put aside some wood paneling for you. Sorry to make you run back and forth when you must be busy already. That's, you know, I mean, it's fine. It's just, I'm here to help. I'm here to be friends with all of my animal friends. Yeah, what are you two doing here? We're gonna talk to Bob. Hey there, King. I see that you have a pink zap suit. I do. That's no good. No good at all. Why are you? Oh no, you've been hanging out with Bob. Oh no, you've picked up Bob's catchphrase. Oh no. I'll be a good friend and trade you that for my Azalea Bonsai. I really don't want to give up the pink zap suit that we just bought. I really don't. But an Azalea Bonsai sounds pretty cool. I'll take it. Oh, really? Oh, good. Okay, then. Let's do this quickly and be done with it. You gotta stop hanging around with Bob. Why are you doing this? That worked out well. I'm glad I could help. Oh, what is happening to my town? It's just gonna be all fart noises before long. Is there anybody else that we could go pay a visit to? That's not the map. There's the map. Violet Bob, Winnie, Lucy, Static, Spork. Is that another new person? I think we have another new person. Alright. Let's just put on the blue zap suit so we don't lose it. Hell yeah. Look at that. Look at how zappy I am. Meow. 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 He just zooming and zapping around. Okay. Let's go. Oh, let's talk to Curly real quick. How are you doing? Oh, this is Spork. How many pigs do we have in town now? Huh? I thought I'd met everyone in town. My name is Spork the Great, but you can call me Spork for short. My house is right by here, so feel free to stop by anytime, Snork. I'm trying out this whole being friends with everyone thing, so see you around. Hey, I'm trying that out too. You must have moved in yesterday, I guess? I just know we're going to be as tight as mac and cheese, Snork. One of the best parts about living on my own is blasting Zydeco as loud as I want. It's so sweet! Well, you do you, buddy. I guess we don't need to go talk to you. Is this a third fossil? What is this? Yeah, look at that. Okay, that's three. How many times did I run by here and just not see it? And that's Agent S. Okay, we could go talk to Curly. Let's go say hello to Curly, and then we'll call it quits for the day. Where? Whose house is that? Winnie. Okay. I'm still trying to get a handle on the layout. And as anyone who's watched any of my videos ever will know, I'm super good at directions. I'm like basically the best at them. Which means this will take no time at all for me to figure out the layout and figure out my way around town, right? Oh, definitely not being sarcastic at all. Hello, Curly. How are you doing? What's up, King? King over to hang out. I did. I like your gyroid. My bad. I'm usually too busy practicing with my extreme table tennis team to clean up. Just slide your feet on the floor while you walk. Maybe he'll pick up some of the dust. Yoink. Yo, hey, King, check this out. See these clothes I threw on? You think I could wear them out and about? Yoink. I can't see what they are because I can't rotate the camera. So... yeah, sure. Looking good. Yeah, phew. Man, whew. If you say it's looking burly, King, I know it's H-Core. Please don't say H-Core ever again. I'm just going to wear this around town to show everyone what's up. Yoink. What are you wearing? Oh, geez. I probably should have said no. Yeah, I'm... Yeah, I don't know about that. You should get yourself, like, a pink or blue zap suit. Then we'll talk. Alright, I got 3D glasses, so I'm really happy with that. Let's see what our wood paneling looks like. Oh, and we have a bonsai to place, also. Someday we'll have this place actually decorated. Hang on, wall. It's fine. I kind of want to get rid of the cardboard box that's in the corner, but we'll get around to that. The azalea should maybe go up here in our bedroom. Bonsai. Am I too close to the wall to place this? Can we not place things in the attic? Why can I not place? I guess we just can't place things in the attic. That's weird. We'll put it over here. Yeah, okay. That is super weird. Oops, nope. Look at that. What a lovely little plant. So I'm always torn. Do we put things like where they would make sense if this were an actual room and people were actually interacting with it? Or do we put things in a way so that like they can be viewed by the audience, by us who are watching and or playing the game? I want to do the first thing, put them in places where it'll all make sense, but I feel obligated to do the second thing because We're not in here looking at it from the different angles. We see it from this angle, so I don't know. And then the paw print, and we can't even like put the wallpaper up here, can we? Yeah, we cannot. Huh, interesting. Can we use the telephone? Oh, it's Rover! Hey there, King! What can I do for you? Oh, it's settings! I will probably tweak that, well, I guess on my own. I guess now. I guess we could just end the video now, and I could just tweak that on my own, because I didn't even think of that. Alright, cool. Thanks for watching, everyone. May the grace of the Twilight Dragon be with you.